In the previous lesson, we learned how to insert blocks from AutoCAD libraries. Although those libraries contain quite some categories with few blocks each, we still may not find the one we want. Of course, we can draw the item and copy it if needed, but that wouldn't make it a single object like a block. In addition, it wouldn't have the same properties that a block has. However, there are in fact two different ways to convert all the objects of a specific item into a single object. The first one is to convert those objects into a block which can be used only in the current drawing. The second one converts those objects into a block that is saved in our computer and enables us to use it repeatedly in any drawing we are working on. To understand this better, I have created a few items in this floor plan, which are not blocks yet, but I am going to convert them into blocks right now. Let's say I'm an architect that has drawn the floor plans of the house you see. Even though I searched for a dining table accompanied by four chairs, I couldn't find one that was to my liking, so eventually I decided to draw my own dining set. I have placed it in the kitchen, but as you can see, it consists of several different and independent objects, such as rectangles and lines. Firstly, I want to convert this dining set into a single object so I can modify it as one. Secondly, I may need to insert this block in the second floor too. However, I do not intend to use this dining set in future projects. Hence, I will go to the Insert ribbon and from the Block Definition panel, I will click on the arrow under the Create Block icon. As you can see, there are two available options there: the Create Block option and the Write Block option. Between the two, I will choose the Create Block option. The window Block Definition appears. In the Name field, I will type the name My Dining Set. Then, I have to specify the base point of the object. To specify the base point, I will click on the Pick Point icon and immediately the window disappears. Now all I have to do is zoom in on the dining set and make sure that the geometric center snap is active before I proceed any further. As we have mentioned before, the geometric center is basically the center of the mass of a two-dimensional planar shape, and it works similarly to the circle center snap. I want to specify the base point on the center of the table, which is actually a rectangle. With the geometric center snap active, I will move the cursor on the perimeter of the table, and once its symbol appears, I will click on it. The block definition window reappears, and this time I have to select the objects which will be parts of the block. So I will click on the icon Select Objects, and once the window disappears again, I will make sure to select all the objects I need to create the block. I will press Enter to make the block definition window appear again. Under the Select Objects icon, I am given three options about the objects I have selected. I can create the block yet retain the objects as they are by choosing Retain. I can create the block and at the same time convert the selected objects into a block too by choosing Convert to Block. Or I can create the block but delete the selected objects by choosing Delete. Since I want to convert the selected objects into a block, I won't change the default option. Under these three options, we can see the total number of the selected items. In this example, I selected 21 objects. In the lower part of the window and the Settings option, I can define the units of the block. Typically, we want the units of the blocks to coincide with the units of the drawing, so I will set meters in this field. In case we want to write a description about this block, we can do it in the Description field on the right. When everything is set, I will click OK to finish the block's creation. Now every time I select the dining set, the table is selected along with the chairs, since they are all parts of the same block. If I want to insert this block again, I can do it from the Insert ribbon and the panel block by clicking the Insert button. The same button is also in the Home ribbon. I will click on the Insert button, and if I do not see the block I created on the list, I can choose to open recent blocks. In the lower right corner, the Blocks palette appears. From the Recent Blocks tab, I can drag and drop another dining set on the second floor. However, remember that this block is not available in other drawings. To prove my point, I will create a new drawing. Notice that in the Recent Blocks tab, my dining set is not available anymore. It has been removed from the list, but I don't mind because, as I mentioned before, I do not plan on using it in another project. However, there is a symbol that an architect uses quite regularly, and this symbol is the symbol that shows the height of an area from zero level. At this point, I will close the blocks palette and return to the drawing I was working with. You can see that symbol in the bedroom of the first floor. This symbol and this number indicate that the bedroom is 25 centimeters above the zero level. When I select the symbol, as you can see, it consists of several different objects. I will convert this symbol into a block, but since I want it to be available in future projects too, I am going to use a different method. I will go to the Insert ribbon, and from the Block Definition panel, I will click on the arrow under the Create Block icon again. This time, I will select the Right Block option. The window Right Block appears, and it is quite similar to the Block Definition window which we previously saw. In the Source field, I will select Objects since I am going to create a new block using some of the objects of the current drawing. Like I did in the previous example of creating a block, I have to specify the base point of the object. So I will click on the Pick Point icon, and once the window disappears, I will zoom in on the symbol. Before I proceed any further, I will make sure that the Center Snap is active. I will specify the base point on the center of the circle. The right block window reappears, and this time I have to select the objects of the block. So I will click on the icon Select Objects, and once the window disappears again, I will make sure to select all the objects of the symbol apart from the number. I will press Enter to make the right block window appear again. Under the Select Objects icon, there are the same three options I also had when I created a block previously. I will create the block, and at the same time, I will convert the selected objects into a block by choosing Convert to Block. This time, the selected objects are four. From the Destination options, I can define the path where the block will be saved and its units. In the File Name and Path field, I can see in which folder of my computer the block is going to be saved. I can change the location by clicking on the three dots next to the path. For this example, I will choose the Desktop folder, and in the Files Name field, I will type the word Symbol. Then I will click on Save. As for the units, we usually want them to coincide with the units of the rest of the drawing, so I will set meters in this field. Once everything is set, I will click OK, and the new block has been created and saved in my computer for further use. Now, if I move my cursor on this symbol, it is highlighted as one object. When I need to insert the symbol again, I will click on the Insert button from the block panel. Then, I will select Blocks from Libraries and find the file in the folder I saved it. I will select it and click Open. The Blocks palette opens again, only this time the Libraries tab is active. I can drag and drop the symbol in the garden and anywhere else in this drawing. I can load this block anytime in any drawing from the folder that was saved.